Are you from Area 51?
Are you from Area 51? Mr. B?
Are you from Area 51? Are you from Area 51?
As you can probably tell from the intro, I'm not an expert in deciding what is and what isn't from Area 51. That's why I've decided to watch this video by the Dobro Brothers. Is this from Area 51? I think we'll get a great insight into what is and what isn't from Area 51. Like, I think they're the experts. They're the ones that are going to know. Let's do this shit. You probably tell my voice is fucked. It's not the bad juju going around, the bad virus in the air. It's a lot of heavy nights of drinking and, yeah, not a lot of sleep. I'll come back in a week's time. Send for help. I'm dead. I'm dying. So the first noteworthy thing in this video is a text convo between the brother and the cameraman. And that goes, yo, by the cameraman. And then the brother goes, going to blaze. That's not how you respond to that greeting. Going to blaze. Do you reckon that anyone on the street says hello to me, he goes, going to blaze? Just going to blaze. One of those fucking awkward kids in fucking school. Just everything. Yeah, I smoke weed. Hey, today. Yeah, well, I smoked weed. I'm fine. At first, I thought this is them agreeing to meet up and smoke some weed, but there was no time or place responded. So I felt like the brother just texted the cameraman, going to blaze, and the cameraman was like, Jesus fucking Christ, I welcome children. Just never text them back again. You'd have thought a heavily edited video like this, meant for millions of children, would let something like that slip through the cracks. It would be hard to reshoot a scene, just crop out the fucking, the text about smoking weed. This leads me to the thing that they wanted that to be on the camera. And what is even more probably likely is the fact that they sent them text specifically to be like, let's make it like we smoke some weed on camera. That'd be good for our image.
Hit it like you don't care. Hit it if you ain't scared. Hit it like you don't care. Hit it if you know you lit.
Then to the text are actually important to the plot of the video, which is to the cameraman from the brother. It says, come to the living room. Come to the living room. Come to the living room. I assume they were all sent within, seconds of each other because there's no fucking timestamps in between them. I can't understand the mind of a person who would send free texts. I wouldn't even send free texts if it was an actual emergency because it'd be inefficient. If I was hit by a fucking car and I was like texting my fucking parents or some shit. Help, I've been hit by a car. Help, I've been hit by a car. Help, I've been hit by a car. Yeah, it's not gonna fucking sort the situation out, is it? Okay. So in response to the text that the brother sent the cameraman does go to the living room and he films the entire process, and it's very slow and very painful to watch. You could argue this is to build dramatic tension, but if you look at the timestamp on the video, you probably realise that it's because they couldn't cut anything out of this video to get ad revenue. Exactly 10 minutes. That takes some skill. That really does.
I mean, you don't have to film this, but like, I'm kind of sick right now, but I took my dog out.
From what I know about the Dobro Brothers, I don't think this is a parody. There was a real point in this man's life where he thought he was going to get caught unaware by the cameraman, and it would look cool if he was wearing glasses and eating a fucking lollipop. He obviously thought the glasses make him look smarter. I don't think it did. For the lollipop, fucked if I know. It just makes him look like he's got the mental age of a fucking 12-year-old.
I'm kind
of
sick right now, but I took my dog out.
Yeah.
Were Lucas and Marcus filming a video by the pool earlier?
I don't think so. Why?
Because there's like a bunch of like glowing, like some glowy liquid, like the stuff that you would find in like a glow stick. Like, yeah. It's just like on the ground outside. So like I wasn't sure if like, if y'all were filming or something.
No.
You weren't?
Yeah, I wasn't, bro, honestly. I wasn't filming.
The boy genius here explains he was out by the pool taking his dog for a walk and he saw some luminous liquid and didn't know what the fuck it was. And he wondered if there was a video that was shot. The cameraman said no. So he decided to go and ask the rest of the house. They ask the brother that's not a twin. I don't know his fucking name. And he has a pretty odd response.
Wait, did you film a video with Christina earlier by the pool?
No. Why?
Because there's like neon like glow stick. Like, looking stuff around the pool.
Dude, you think I'm dumb? You guys are recording right now.
Huh?
Like, I'm not dumb. You guys are recording.
No, right? I know. Yeah, we are recording. I know.
Yeah, why? You're trying to pull a prank on me right now or something?
You think I'm a fucking idiot, bro? Look at these fucking pecs, man. I am not as fucking stupid as you. I will not believe your fucking stupid stories, man. I know this shit. What even kind of prank is that, man? The fucking luminous liquid prank. When I bring over and look at this luminous liquid, you're gonna stick a fucking firework up my ass and fucking light it. Jesus, man, these guys are fucking next level shit when it comes to pranks, because there's like way beyond the sort of pranks I would think of.
No, I was just asking you, I was asking everyone if you guys know what that is at, by the pool, because I don't know who put that there.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, it's like some glowy, neon.
Did you see something by the pool, bro?
Yeah.
There is something by the pool.
I'm pretty sure I'm talking that. I know what you're talking about.
Yo, Lucas, Marcus.
And then this brother just fucking prances around the house, fucking shouting, "Yo, man, he's trying to pull a fucking prank on us." He's literally waking everyone. I don't know. I'm an old man. It's like 10 o'clock. I'd be asleep, but he's coming around shouting, getting everyone out of their fucking bedrooms because of this. "Yo, man, he's trying to fucking pull a fast one on us."
They're trying to send us some weird stuff by the pool.
Why is he yelling so loud, bro? Man, he's trying to prank us right now.
It's 1 a.m, bro. Like,
hey, we're just trying to go to sleep.
I'm trying to sleep too. I'm tired.
Well, I'll fuck myself then. It's not 10 o'clock. It's fucking 1 o'clock in the morning. So he was going around waking everyone up. They have a cold conversation about it. I mean, brother one said he was trying to sleep anyway, even though he was texting people saying, "Come into my fucking bedroom." And I tell you, I'm going to spin a yarn about some luminous liquid lying around the pool. So he obviously wasn't trying to sleep. The other ones come out like half dressed saying they were trying to sleep, which is bizarre. And then brother fucking three, I'm just going to give them numbers because I don't know their fucking names. The one running around the house shouting, there's the one going, "Hey, you're waking everyone up, man." You were the one fucking prancing around fucking shouting about it.
He's definitely sleepwalking right now. Are you awake?
I'll show you guys.
The fact that they say he was sleepwalking as well. This is the best excuse for anything ever. In core, like, did you murder that man? I was probably sleepwalking, to be honest. But your eyes are open. And, you know, you were talking full sentences. But I was sleepwalking. It was 1 a.m, man. I was tired. It would you'd definitely get off the hook. It would work.
Come here, guys.
Okay.
That green thing?
That's why I brought you out. I don't know what it is. I think it's just like, I was gonna see if you guys like left it here.
Why is it different colors?
My dog was like about to lick it too.
I don't think you should touch that more.
Then we have the scene where they'll go out and actually look at the slime, which is real. It's really there. He wasn't sleepwalking, which, you know, it could have fooled me. And yeah, like, it seems like some time passes in this scene. It seems like there was a while they were staring at this. It seems like they were out there for fucking hours, man. It starts to disappear. And the convo's boring the entire fucking time. Can you imagine the cameraman having to sit there for an hour? Listen to him and like, "Oh, Jesus Christ. What the fuck am I going to keep out of this conversation?" Think about dubs he can make.
Does it lead to something?
I just touched it. Nothing happened. I'm good. Did you guys use slime again for a video?
We did slime a while ago.
Yeah, what is this?
There's some in the grass too.
Is it like alien or something?
I don't know.
Yo, what?
Bro, come on now. What is that, like, some kind of like...
I know, right?
What we could do is check the camera.
So the next scene's a little awkward. They start using a black light that they use for crime scenes to see what else they can find.
You guys do like a new slime prank or something?
It's all in the grass and stuff.
Yo, what's on your body?
What?
Yo, what's on your body?
What?
Wait.
It's on your body, bro.
What's on my body?
No, it's all on your body. Don't act like you can't see it.
Bro.
We told you not to touch it.
What are you talking about? I just see a bunch of glow in the grass right now. You don't see the glow in the grass?
What?
Bro, there's a path that goes right there.
Bro, what are you talking about,
Cyrus? Yeah, there's a path right here.
What?
Come on, let's go.
Bro, what are you talking about,
Cyrus? Dude, it's right, look, it's like all bright green. Come here, come on.
So the lady in white here sees a little trail hidden in the ground. And it's not a trail that I would sort of want to follow or go near, but they all seem to, and I'm glad they did, because at least a very, very important discovery.
Sai,
yo,
where you at?
Yo,
you good, Sai?
Cyrus,
hey, what are you doing? Stop acting like that.
Cyrus, come on, I brought you a flashlight,
what's going
bro.
On?
Yeah.
Here, come on.
Wait.
Stop acting sketchy, bro.
Yo, what the heck? Yo, what is that? Yo, what?
The first video footage of extraterrestrials, and it ends up looking like a couple of fucking crackheads dogging at the local park.
Come on.
Wait.
I like the sketch, bro.
The alien emerges from the bushes, confused and shielding his eyes with the bright lights. And the brother has a face that makes me think he wasn't expecting to like the anal probe as much as he did.
Come on.
Wait.
I like the sketch, bro.
When their brother is in peril, the Dobra brothers prove their status as the heroes of this story.
Dad, yo, what?
Alright, what is that?
I don't know, forget
that. Ah, my head hurts.
Nah, no way, bro.
That's right. Not only do they run from the scene where the brother is being forced into acts of possibly a sexual nature, possibly from a being from out of this world that's possibly on large amounts of crack cocaine, but they also find the time to moan about a headache.
Hey, what is that?
I don't know, forget that.
Ah, my head hurts.
Nah, no way, bro. Here, you dropped this.
I know, I got scared.
What are you doing? What's going on right now?
Can we get out of here? Come on.
Bro, why was that alien right behind him? I told you guys about these late night pranks. Come on. I'm actually not feeling
it. We didn't say it. We
didn't even know about this.
Bro, yo, we gotta go back. We gotta go back.
I'm telling you guys, like, I'm tired of these pranks. I'm gonna tell Cyrus right now.
Yo,
I'm not feeling well.
So they run to the porch, spend about 30 seconds getting around in circles about whether this is a prank or not, then decide they should probably go back and help their brother that's potentially in a weird, you know, sexual situation with an extraterrestrial. But when they get back to the area where the brother was, he disappeared. And so ZT. It's fucking scary times, man. And the cameraman decides to interject with a question that's, you know, parallel to the sort of thing that Louis Theroux would ask in one of his hard-hitting documentaries.
Oh, really? No,
wait, what?
He's not there.
Why?
Wait, what? Imagine this dude was on CSI. Chief, the victim was found bound and gagged and forced mackerel until he died. Why? How could I possibly know that? I just got here. That bit doesn't come to the final act. Why? You're fired. Handed your badge and your gun. I didn't get either of those things. I just got a camera. Okay, well, give me that. And your shoes.
Yo, he could be hiding.
No, he's not there.
Yo, Steve, where is he, bro? Huh?
I don't know.
Cyrus!
Alright, does anyone know? Is this a prank or not? Like,
no, of course not.
I know this. I'm not pranking anyone,
Cyrus.
So
it's been a good while just in the same fucking spot. Just asking each other, have you seen him? No, I haven't seen him. Have you seen him? No, I haven't seen him. What about over there? No, he's not over there. What about over there? No, he's not over there. Instead of actually fucking walking around and looking for him. Then, one of my favourite quotes of all time gets uttered.
Yo, what is that?
Yo, Cy! Yo!
Whoa.
He's being abducted by Area 51!
Spielberg was kicking himself after he heard that line, as if that was never used in E.T. Also, the term kidnapping is very loose here.
Cy! Why are you with the alien right now? Yo, back up!
Wait, what?
I just saw a blink.
Cyrus?
This is the most placid kidnapping I've ever seen. You know, in fiction. I haven't watched real kidnappings take place in real life. Do nothing to help and then rate them on severity. Yeah, that's quite a bad one. Give that 6. Placid. Give that 1. It's nothing. Personally, I've never seen a kidnapping where the victim is a foot taller than his kidnapper. Also, I've never seen the kidnappee perform the over-the-shoulder titty grab on the kidnapper. That seems a bit inappropriate.
Cyrus.
What is that?
To me, this doesn't give out kidnapper vibes. It's more of an estranged relationship between a father and a son. A father who never wanted to be a dad and a son who doesn't like his dad. Probably the funniest thing about this entire situation is the fact that they were laughing on their approach to these people. Because they thought it was a funny concept. And they see the seriousness of the situation and they stop laughing.
What is he doing, yo?
Then Emily Rose here does a real shitty impression of Patrick Stewart. And that makes him angry enough. I think he realises how bad he is at acting. And that's what makes him so angry. He just fucking charges like a bull at the other brothers. And they're so scared they run all the way home.
Yo, Cyrus.
Let him talk.
More, go, bad. Cyrus, come on, seriously, are you good, man?
Yo, talk to her.
No.
This is our planet.
But when they get home, there's a surprise waiting for them at the doorway. It's mum and dad when they know you snuck out to buy some crack. So, they run away again, this time to the security guard.
What's going on, guys?
Hey, what's up, bro? Have you seen, like, Cyrus or, like, anyone or anything else on this property?
Nah, I saw Cyrus pulling about an hour ago. I haven't seen anything since then.
Really?
Yeah. Mm.
I hope this dude got the fucking sack, man. His only job is to sit outside in the truck and make sure nothing weird happens. Somehow during this process, a fucking skinny, grey creature that moves like rigor mortis is already set in, manages to creep into the back of his truck. All I can imagine is whispering in a failed cop's ears. Tell them you haven't seen me. Now tell them you think aliens are cool and have big dicks. They're leaving, you idiot! You useless piece of shit! Then after that, they run away for the fourth, and then the fifth time, and one of them has a real intense acid flashback.
How did he get in there? Alright.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Where? Where?
Yeah.
It sounds like they kept this in to make him look like a little fucking bitch boy, because it's the only one that sees him to start with. But then when everyone else notices, and they're like, what are you fucking screaming about, man? Despite the fact that a minute ago, they're all fucking running for their life.
Are you sure? Where?
Oh my god!
Oh, he is there.
Oh.
Yo, how'd he get inside the house?
Bro, what is this? What is going on right now?
Maybe just trying to say hi to us or something? Like,
it's like, you know, you ever see someone lose their temper in public? And they look like a fucking idiot. And you think, God, man, that's what I look like when I lose my temper. I wonder if that's what happened here. I wonder if the other day members watched this guy fucking screaming for his life like a little girl. And they were like, oh man, is that what I look like the last fucking scene? Nah, I ain't doing that again, man. Fucking joke's over. Let's end the fucking video here, man. Let's play it cool. 8 minutes. 8 fucking minutes into a 10-minute video.
Yo, back up.
This is like some Area 51.
Oh, what?
He disappeared.
Whoa.
Yo, is that alien actually moving right now? Or
yeah.
Is this a nightmare right now? Am I
dreaming? No.
Is that what he constitutes as fucking moving? It slides back like it's being pulled on a fucking string.
Like some Area 51.
Oh, what?
It disappeared.
Whoa.
Yo, is that alien actually moving right now? Or
yeah.
Is this a nightmare right now? Am I
dreaming? No.
I'd love to just go to a fucking magic show, man. His mind would be blown the entire time. Is that tank moving right now?
No.
No, I'm definitely asleep right now, bro.
This sounds like the detective reasoning of a detective that's been working way too many hours. The only possible reason for this is that I'm asleep, and none of this is real. I've been asleep the whole time. It's the only logical explanation. Imagine that as a fucking magic debunker. So, sir, how do you think the tank moved? We're asleep. All of us, we all slept at the same time, and while we're asleep, the tank slowly drove out of here, and none of us woke up. It's the only way.
Boy, what are you doing?
What? Cyrus! What's up? What are you doing, bro?
What are you guys doing?
And now for the quick fire round.
Why are the lights off in the house? Did you lock us out? What's up with the alien stuff?
This line of questions is used by the brightest and the most drunk cops. Just ask a load of random questions trying to baffle your subject into submission. When's the next train? Cool, this or what's it? What's going on with your murdered wife? I get the YouTube subtitles are, you know, auto-generated. They can't write them out for every video. It's just, you know, it sounds like they say. But this is the real teasy.
You were with some like alien. I'm trying to sleep. I'm sick. What was that? Was that you? You were like out on the field.
What was
like
me? I was just chilling.
Nah, bro. Stop playing.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Dang, that's bright.
Honestly, I don't know what you guys are talking about. I don't feel like recording anymore tonight. I'm going to bed, man. I'm tired. All right.
Bro, what do you mean? This was definitely like, you guys, come on, boy. Let's go to bed.
I mean, I definitely did not know what was going on with you. Huh? Honestly.
Nah, I didn't.
Good night, guys.
Okay, night.
And so, in the end, it turns out none of them can really agree on what happened. And we all got a little bit stupider along the way.
Night.
Now let's talk about the alien. It's not real. I mean, I'm not a fucking idiot. Of course it's not real. It doesn't look real at all. And I'm fine with that. I'm fine with, like, you know, movies and plays, they use props that, like, the viewers aren't supposed to think are real, but the actors pretend like they're real. But this one is such a fucking weird middle ground of the viewers don't think it looks real, but the actors sometimes don't think it looks real. They think it's a prank half the time. They're like, this doesn't look like a real alien. So what the fuck are you supposed to think? The actors have to sell it. If the actors sell this a real performance for like a real alien, you think, oh, you know, you can play in your head a little bit. But the actors even don't believe it. What the fuck are you supposed to believe? It's ridiculous. At this point, they're just being scared of a literal doll. It's literally like the brothers carrying a doll around and they're fucking scared of it the whole time. And based on the reactions of everyone involved, I think we conclude that this isn't from Area 51. It's a fucking doll. Good night.